Gopijana Vallabha Girivaradhari. Yashoda Nandana Brajanarandana Yamuna Tira Vanachari. Yamuna Tira Vanachari. Yamuna Tira Vanachari. Jai Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. Gopi Jana Vallabha Girivaradhari. Gopi Jana Vallabha Girivaradhari. Yashoda Nandana Brajanaranjana Yamuna Tira Vanachari. Yamuna Tira Vanachari. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Shri Harinam Sankirtan ki, Shrimad Bhagavatam ki, Shri Prabhupada ki, Vidai Gau Premanande, Hare Hare Bol. All glories to assembled devotees, Hare Krishna. All glories to assembled devotees, Hare Krishna. All glories to assembled devotees, Hare Krishna. All glories, all glories, all glories to Shri Guru and Shri Gauranga. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 9, Chapter 24, entitled Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Text number 58. यन्माया चेष्टितं पुंसा स्थिति उत्पत्ति अपयायहि अनुग्रहस्तन्निवृत्ते आत्मलाभाय चेष्यते यन्माया चेष्टितं पुंसा स्थिति उत्पत्ति अप्ययायहि अनुग्रहस्तन्निवृत्ति आत्मलाभाय चेष्यते यन्माया चेष्टितं पुंसा स्थिति उत्पत्ति अप्ययायहि अनुग्रहस्तन्निवृत्तेर् आत्मलाभाय चेष्यते Mataji. Word to word meaning, yad, whatever, maya cheshtitam, the laws of material nature enacted by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, pumsa of the living entities, sthiti, duration of life, utpatti, birth, apyaya, annihilation, he indeed, anugraha, compassion, tad nivritte, the creation and manifestation of cosmic energy to stop the repetition of birth and death, atma labhaya, thus going home back to Godhead. Cha, indeed. Ishyate, for this purpose, the creation is there. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Translation. The Supreme Personality of Godhead acts through His material energy in the creation, maintenance and annihilation of this cosmic manifestation just to deliver the living entity by His compassion and stop the living entity's birth, death and duration of materialistic life. Thus he enables the living being to return home back to Godhead. Purport. Materialistic men sometimes ask why God has created the material world for the suffering of the living entities. The material creation is certainly meant for suffering of conditioned souls who are part and parcel of Supreme Personal Godhead, as confirmed by Lord himself in Bhagavad Gita. Mamai vamsho jiva loke jiva bhuta sanatana manashashtyani indriyani prakritistani karshati. The living entities in the conditioned world are my eternal fragmental parts. Due to conditioned life, they are struggling very hard with the six senses, which include the mind. All the living entities are part and parcel of the Supreme Personal Godhead and are as good as the Lord qualitatively. But quantitatively, there is a great difference between them. For the Lord is unlimited, whereas the living entities are limited. Thus, Lord possesses unlimited potency for pleasure, and the living entities have a limited pleasure potency. Anandmayo bhyasat. Both the Lord and the living entity, being qualitatively spirit soul, they have a tendency for peaceful enjoyment. But when the part of the Supreme Personal Godhead unfortunately wants to enjoy independently without Krishna, he is put into the world where he begins his life as Brahma and gradually degraded to the status of an ant or a worm in the stool. This is called Manashashtani Indriyani Prakarshitani Karshati. There is a great struggle for existence because living entity conditioned by material nature is under nature's full control. Prakriti Kriyamani Gunai Karmani Sarvasha. Because of his limited knowledge, however, the living entity thinks he is enjoying in this material world. Manashashtani Indriyani Prakarshitani Karshati. He is actually under the full control of material nature, but still he thinks himself independent. Even when he is elevated by the speculative knowledge and tries to merge into the existence of Brahman, the same disease continues. Aruya krushena param padam tatha patanti adha. Even having attained that param padam, having merged into the impersonal Brahman, he falls again to this material world. In this way, the conditioned soul undergoes a great struggle for existence in this material world, and therefore the Lord, out of compassion for him, appears in this world and instructs him. Thus Lord says in Bhagavad Gita, Yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata abhyutthanam adharmasya tadatmanam shujamyaham. Whenever and wherever there is decline of religious practice, O descendant of Bharat, a predominant rise of religion, at that time I descend myself. The real dharma is to surrender unto Krishna, but rebellious living entity, instead of surrendering to Krishna, engages in adharma, in struggle for existence to become like Krishna. Therefore, out of compassion, Krishna creates this material world to give living entity a chance to understand his real position. Bhagavad Gita and similar Vedic literatures are presented so that living being may understand his relationship with Krishna. Vedech sarvair aham eva vedyo. All these Vedic literatures are meant to enable human being to understand what he is, what is his actual position, and what his relationship with Supreme Personality of Godhead is. This is called Brahma Jigyasa. Every conditioned soul is struggling, but human life provides the best chance for him to understand his position. Therefore, this verse says, Anugrahastan Nivrite, indicates that the false life of repeated birth and death must be stopped, and conditioned soul should be educated. This is the purpose of creation. The creation does not arise whimsically, as atheistic men think. Asatyam apratishtam te jagat ahur anishwaram aparaspara sambhutam kim anyat kam haitukam. They say that this world is unreal, that there is no foundation and there is no God in control. It is produced of sex desire and has no cause other than lust. Atheistic rascals think that there is no God and that the creation has taken place by chance. Just as a man and woman meet by chance and the woman becomes pregnant and gives birth to a child. Actually, however, this is not the fact. The fact is that there is purpose for this creation, to give the conditioned soul a chance to return to its original consciousness, Krishna consciousness, and then return home back to Godhead, and be completely happy in the spiritual world. In the material world, the conditioned soul is given a chance to satisfy his senses, but at the same time, he is informed by Vedic knowledge that this material world is not his actual place for happiness. Janma mrityu jara vyadi dukkha doshan darshanam. One must stop the repetition of birth and death. Every human being, therefore, should take advantage of this creation by understanding Krishna and his relationship with Krishna, and in this way, return home back to Godhead. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Gananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Sri Chaitanya Manobishtam Sampitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Nadati Svaprantikam Vandeham Sri Guru Sri Yudha Padagamalam Sri Guru Vaishnavamsha Sri Rupam Sagrajatam Sagana Raghunathan Vitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Saitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padan Sagana Lalita Sri Vishakamitamsha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishnaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swami Nitinamine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Pashyanta Deshatarine Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pranayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namine Gaura Tushe Nama He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopikakanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi, Sri Radhe Vrindavaneshwari, Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye, Nilachala Nivasaya Nityaya Paramatmane Balabhadra Subhadrabhyam Jagannathaya Te Nama, Vancha Kalpatrubhyasya, Kripa Sindhu Bevacha, Paditanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Nama, Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya, Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Srivasadi Gaurabhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. So I seek blessings of all Vaishnavas assembled here, especially Janivas Prabhu and other senior Vaishnavas to bless me so that I can speak something for my own purification. Actually, I have no qualification to sit here and give class, but senior Vaishnavas asked me to speak. So I'm trying my efforts. We see Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he went to South India, when he came to Sri Ranga, he saw there was one Brahmana. He was reading Bhagavad Gita, though he was illiterate. So, when asked why he is reading, he said, because this was the instruction of his spiritual master. So, though he was illiterate, because it was instruction, he tried to execute it without considering his disqualifications. Mercy of Vaishnavas is more powerful than our disqualifications. So, we see, though he was illiterate, just because he executed his service, he got the mercy of the Lord and he could realize Krishna. And he could realize Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna. So, I hope that though I am not qualified, I take it as instruction, execute, and I will see all of your mercy. So, I can continue in Krishna consciousness. Nicely. So today's verse is a beautiful verse. We see Srila Prabhupada has started his system of every day studying one verse of Bhagavatam. We see in this world people are suffering, but they don't know the cause of suffering. In Srimad Bhagavatam, Avanti Brahmana explains that I am not suffering because of my karma, which most people think that suffering because of that. And he said, I am not suffering because of influence of planets. Some people think that they are suffering because maybe Mangal is there, Shani is there, you know. He said, I am not suffering because of it. And he said, I am not suffering because of other living entities. Most times we feel, oh, I am suffering because maybe this Prabhu or this Mata or this, you know, is creating trouble for me. But he said, I am not suffering because of that. And then he says that I am suffering because of this uncontrolled mind. Only cause of my suffering is this uncontrolled mind. Similarly, we see Hiranyakashipu, 7th canto. He practically conquered all the three worlds. He had so much influence just by his mere movement of eyebrow. Even sun and moon used to be terrified. That person was also not very happy. And Srimad Bhagavatam explains, because he failed to control his senses and especially his mind. So, mind can be controlled by actually intelligence. Intelligence superior to mind. And intelligence, real intelligence means words of Guru, Sadhu, Shastras. That's what strengthens our intelligence, pure intelligence. So every day hearing from Bhagavatam, every day hearing from Sadhus, Vaishnavas, that can actually strengthen our intelligence and help to control mind so that we can practice Krishna consciousness steadily and go in right direction. This Bhagavatam has appeared, Krishna himself has appeared in this dark age to give us light. Krishna sudhama upagate dharma jnana divisa kalau nashta drushamisha puranarko dhunodita. This Bhagavatam is supposed to give light. He is giving light, and we can take advantage of Bhagavatam to get the vision, get the direction in life, and lead our life accordingly. So here, in today's verse, everybody can read 9:24:58. The Supreme Person of Godhead acts through his material energy in the creation, maintenance and annihilation of this cosmic manifestation just to deliver the living entity by his compassion and stop the living entity's birth, death and duration of materialistic life. Thus he enables the living being to return home back to Godhead. So this verse says that this creation has a purpose, and purpose is to deliver conditioned souls from this materialistic life and take them back home, back to Godhead. And this is anugraha. This is great mercy of Supreme Person of Godhead. Sometimes materialistic people think, oh, why Lord has created this material world? This is dukkhalayam, this is ashashvatam, so miserable. Why God wants to make me so miserable? Why can't He make me happy? Why can't He create a world where I can be always happy? So yes, He has created a world where we can always be happy. That is spiritual world. But then we have to live as per the etiquettes in the spiritual world, as per the rules in the spiritual world, then we can be happy. But those who disobey the laws of God, they are sent to this material world for rectification. And even this material world is also anugrahaya, compassion of the Lord. We see in the material world, every city practically has prison house or jail. Now those who are disobedient to the laws of government, they are put in jail so that they can be reformed. And actually that is the mercy of government. If government wants, they say, those who are disobedient to the government, we'll just kill them. Why so much headache of constructing prison house, maintaining it, feeding it, and it's so much of trouble. But government is taking that trouble. Why? Out of mercy, because they are concerned for the citizens. They want the welfare of the citizens. So prison house is actually compassion of government. Nowadays, since prison house people have negative notion about it, or jail, when you see jail or prison house, people immediately develop negativity. So they have changed the name of prison house in India. They call prison house as, now what they call? They call it as correctional centers. They don't call now prison house, they call it correctional centers. So living entities are sent there for correction, so that they can rectify, they can reform themselves, and they can become better gentlemen. So this prison house or this correction centers are not like concentration camps. Like we see Hitler had concentration camps, or some, you know, dictators had concentration camp to kill the people, to make them suffer. This is not like that. This is anugraha. This world itself is born out of great compassion. We see Supreme Lord is eternally enjoying the spiritual world with his very loving and dear assets. But just so that to facilitate those who are disobedient, those who are little, you know, want to enjoy independence, he expands himself. We see he expands himself in form of Mahavishnu, Garbhodakshaya Vishnu, Shirodakshaya Vishnu, and he creates so many planets. He creates 14 planetary systems, and he creates so many arrangements. He has created so many 8.4 million species, and he has made all arrangement, and he has also made arrangement for their maintenance, for their, you know, all this thing. So it's a great effort on the part of Lord to facilitate independent living entity. And we see living entity, when it comes to the material world, he is given the post of Brahma. We see in today's verse Prabhupada saying living entity comes and becomes Brahma. Brahma, where, you know, he's most intelligent, so much intelligence, he has so much facility, so much, you know. But then because of, again, misusing his free will, then one can degrade from Brahma's position, lower and lower and lower. And living entity can go so lowly because of his lowly desire that he can even become worm in the stool. Can you imagine? Coming from spiritual world to material world itself is big degradation. And from material world, also from Brahma's position to becoming worm in the stool. What a degradation. But still, Lord never leaves a living entity. No matter how living entity desires to degrade to whatever, Lord always is with him. He never leaves living entity. And Lord is so kind and merciful. He allows living entity to commit mistake and learn. And he is always forgiving. He is ready to forgive. In spite of so many mistakes, he is always ready to forgive. And he is so kind that he never closes the door of spiritual world. Anytime living entity wants to come back, his door to Vaikuntha, go to Golokrunda is always open. He never says, now you have done so much abominable activities, you are so degraded, now get lost. He is always kind. Rather, he is always looking forward to get an opportunity so that he can induce living entity to reform and come back to the spiritual world. And he is very, very patient. Can you imagine? We see living entity, millions of lifetimes, he's just going through different bodies, trying to enjoy different things, and still living Lord as Paramatma patiently is with him, never gives up on him. Sometimes we see a son is not cooperating, father may try his best and then finally forget it, no, do whatever he wants, he may just ignore him. But Supreme Lord is such a father that he never neglects. He's always attentive, very, very attentive. Even if living entity shows little desire to be Krishna, God immediately arranges various facilities, immediately arranges some ways by which he can progress. So Lord is very compassionate. And this material world is his compassion. This material has not come by chance. Like once Prabhupada was giving talk And when he was giving class, one student got up and said, Swamiji, you are talking about Bhagavad Gita? But I heard just Dr. J. Mallard got Nobel Prize for his chance theory. He said, everything has come by chance. So if everything has come by chance, where is the role of your God? And Prabhupada just looked at him and he said, my dear sir, you said that everything has come by chance. Does that not mean that even chance theory has come by chance? I imagine if chance theory has come by chance, why give him Nobel Prize? What a scientist want to say that everything has come by chance except my chance theory. My chance theory requires a lot of intelligence. So Prabhupada said even chance theory doesn't come by chance. It also requires a person. What to speak of this entire creation? So this creation is there. Is the arrangement of Lord. Sometimes because Lord is very kind, He keeps Himself invisible so that living entity can think themselves in control and get that joy and pride of, you know, being the doer. Ankar vimudatma kartaham iti manyate. But actually reality, living entity is very helpless. Living entity can only desire. And when Lord in the heart says if He deserves or in His, and then He sanctions, then He instructs material nature and material nature executes. Prakriti kriyamanani gunai karmani sarusha. Everything is executed by the material nature, under the instruction of Lord, not under the instruction of living entity. Living entity may instruct, but material nature will not execute. When Lord instructs, Lord sanctions, then material energy executes. So what is happening here in this world actually is happening by grace of Lord. We are able to move hands, we are able to talk. This is also mercy of Lord. When I want to leave this book, and then I desire to leave the book, and when Krishna sanctions, material energy executes through the mechanical arrangement of this hands and body, you know. Like we see, we have JCB machines, very huge, you know. This driver is pushes the button and such huge sand and mud and all these things pulled. That is all mechanical arrangements. So similarly, this body is a mechanical arrangement. When Lord sanctions, the material energy executes. But ankar vimudatma kartaham iti man. We think, I am doing. We see sometimes, we may desire to lift a book, but if Lord doesn't sanction, we may get paralyzed. Our hand may get paralyzed. We may not be able to lift our hand also, you know. So, sometimes we are able to speak now. Sometimes it may so happen that we may not be able to speak also. Even whatever we are able to do in this world, actually, we are able to do by mercy of Krishna. Krishna is behind everything. And because we don't know, we are ungrateful. When one comes to knowledge, krutagnya, when one comes to knowledge, he can understand things, how things are working, and then he becomes grateful. We see sometimes iron filings. There is a magnet below, and you move the magnet, iron filings move. One may think, alright, so nice. But actually, why iron filings are moving? Because there is a magnet below. If you remove the magnet, then iron filings will not move. So in this world, every living entity is a mood. There are no under the direction of Lord. Similarly, you know, this puppet. Sometimes puppeteer is not sin, but it's moving because of puppeteer. So Lord is a supreme puppeteer. Everything is moving as per His will, as per His direction. And His will is actually to stop the suffering of living entities and bring them back home, back to Godhead. So one should have proper understanding towards Lord and Lord's arrangement. If one develops proper attitude based on proper knowledge of Shastras, then we can progress nicely in spiritual life. But if one becomes envious of God, envious of representatives of God, envious of arrangements of Lord, systems of Lord, then one can degrade more and more. So it's very important that, you know, we see the things in right perspective and develop appreciation for Lord and be grateful to God and His representatives and His arrangements. And whatever actually, so in this world, because of ignorance we think we are the doers, we think we are proprietors, we are enjoyers, and with that consciousness when we act, we keep on degrading more and more. Unless some Vaishnava comes in our life, unless somehow we are enlightened and we are able to see things as they are, we are able to sing the presence of God, we are able to see the arrangements of Lord, and we are able to then live accordingly. His Holiness Bhaktivedanta Maharaj, in his one of his seminars, he gives 10 tips how we can live in this world so that actually the purpose of the world, which is to deliver living entities back home, back to God, is achieved. He says whenever we are living, we should understand the goal of this whole material creation is actually spiritual, not material. Goal of life is not material. So he recommends this 10 meditations. First meditation, he says that whatever, sometimes we have many material desires in our heart. Oh, we want to become very rich, we want to become very famous, we want to become very beautiful, or whatever opulence we want to purchase in life. He says once, sometimes we should reflect. Imagine I have achieved all that. Whatever wealth I want to achieve, I have achieved. Whatever fame I want to achieve, I have achieved. Imagine we achieved that. So what? What of it? What for? Even if we achieve all these things, it won't satisfy our heart. It won't make us happy, because that is not the goal of life. These are material things. So, when we reflect some things, then we can keep our life in proper perspective, and we will know where to endeavor and where we should not too much. Okay, material life is important, body is important, we need to maintain it. But not that just material life becomes the goal of life and material development becomes, you know, that may be unfortunate. Second meditation, he says that we should reflect that I am not this body. Body is a vehicle. Like we may have Mercedes Benz, definitely we should take care of it. But how much time we should give for it? And imagine we just give 24 hours to the car, washing car, decorating car, nice, but we don't use it to go for destination. What is the use of it? So he said that we should remember this body is just a car. Maintain it but use for destination. And not get too much caught up. Especially when we are too much suffering, miserable. If you just reflect, I am not this body. I have been given this body. Suppose we are working in some company, company uses car. We are duty bound to use that car in service of company. So this body is given by God. We are duty bound to use this body, mind in service of God. And it's not ours. And we are not the body. So little reflections can help us detach from the situation. Sometimes we see somebody breaks the window of the car. Imagine we have Mercedes Benz and window is broken. Somebody throws stone. Immediately our heart breaks. And it's so painful. But we understand, I am not the car. So it can be similarly, sometimes body, some things happen, it can affect so much. But little reflection can help us to detach ourselves. Similarly, third reflection, he says that we should reflect and try to see other points of view in our life. Sometimes we think, I am the control, I am the enjoyer, I am center of the world, and we expect that whole world and everybody should align with our desires. But actually this world is not designed to align with our desires. This world is going to align according to Lord's desire. So we should not imagine ourselves to be center and expect that. That may lead to very miserable experience. So we should try to see other point of view also. We have imperfect senses, we have some perspective, some understanding, but we can also see from others' perspective, others' understanding, then we'll have get better picture to move ahead. We see a lot of conflicts in life happens because we think what I see is right, and we only so much put faith on our own vision, our own understanding, our own perceptions and we don't value others. So then so much conflict happens, so much misery happens. So he says we should try to understand others' point of view also. Then we can better resolve the conflicts. And fourth point he says that we should reflect that. Try to see God everywhere. We see Prabhupada went to Bowery, America, New York. And devotees were very sorry that, oh, so dirty, so abominable, we have brought him for program here. They were little apologistic. But Prabhupada said, oh, this is Vaikuntha, this kingdom of God. So he was able to see Krishna even there. And Harishabhu in one of his talk, he was saying that actually we are hippies, we are not lovable people. But Prabhupada loved us so much. Because he was able to see us also as part and parcel of Krishna, eternal servant of Krishna. So he was very kind and affectionate. So trying to see everything in relation with Krishna, trying to see everyone in relation with Krishna, trying to see Krishna in every situation. So that can make us, that can give us spiritual vision. Fifth reflection, he says that we should see that everything has a purpose. Nothing is by chance and there are no accidents in this world. So whatever happens, we should see, oh, this is Krishna's arrangement. Sometimes we may not be able to see how it is good, but we should have that faith that yes, it's good. I remember when I was a small boy, I wanted to get very good marks in my class, and you know, I used to get less marks. So I was desperate. So my mother told me the story of this Dhruva Maharaj, and she said, just see, Dhruva wanted such a great thing. He approached Lord, he worshipped Lord and got what he wanted. So I was very inspired. Then she told me to chant the holy names. So I started chanting the holy names of Lord. And actually I was very intense in chanting. And I saw when I chanted very intensely for some period of time. Later on when exam came, I got the first rank in my class. Then I developed faith, yes, God is very merciful. God fulfills our desire. So I became very attached to the chanting. I knew if I chant nicely, I will get good marks. So in my schools, almost everywhere, exams used to come, I used to really more intensely chant. Then I saw 3rd standard, 4th standard, 5th standard, 6th standard, 10th standard, you know. I got very good grade because I always know that if I chant, Krishna will really help. Then after I went to college, somehow by Krishna's mercy I met devotees. And then I started attending programs. And then somehow later on I started getting less marks. Though I was studying and it was so shocking. One time I got so less, I couldn't believe how it can happen. It was so heartbreaking, so miserable experience. And then devotees consoled me, my dear Prabhu, don't worry, you know, it's Krishna's mercy, you know. And then I read Prabhupada books, because when difficulties come, we become more reflective, more, you know, serious. And I read about Kunti's prayers, let there be calamities. Oh, calamities are very good. So Krishna arranges calamities for our good. And then I realized, oh, just working for material things is not actually very good. We should work for serving Krishna. Till now I have been just thinking of I and Maya, you know, and using only for... So when reading Prabhupada books, hearing from devotees, realized that we should serve Krishna. And then I started saying, in serving we started getting so much joy and happiness in serving. And many years passed. And then later on I saw the service which I was attached, the service was taken away. And again it was so miserable experience. I was doing this service and this was nice and then service is taken away. So miserable again. Again we reflect, again we take association of devotees, again read Prabhupada, again hear, you know. Then again I say, yes, this is Krishna's mercy. Sometimes when situation comes painful, but if you understand, oh, it's Krishna's mercy, let me take it. And then we can. Later on we can understand, oh, it's a really mercy. When I reflect back, then I understand, oh, I got less mercy that time. Very mercy, great mercy. Oh, my service was changed. Oh, it's great mercy. So that time we may not understand, but then later on, if we can follow the instructions of devotees and Krishna, accept the will of Krishna, and happily again engage our mind and senses enthusiastically in serving Krishna, then we say it's very wonderful. And sometimes, so in the beginning we may serve Krishna for our own desires. Later on we may serve Krishna to please Krishna, but we have so many our ulterior motives. But Krishna arranged in such a way that we can serve Him without ulterior motives, because that is actually for our real welfare. Krishna says, sarva dharman paritya mam ekam sharanam vraja. Just surrender to Me. He is telling us surrender to Him completely because it is for our good. He doesn't need anything. Because we are attached, sometimes, you know, we suffer. So, Badrinath Maharaj tells how he came to Krishna consciousness. He said, when he first time got Prabhupada book, he read it, he was very inspired, and then he came to temple and he heard Sunday feast class, and he thought, this was the most intelligent talk I ever heard in my life. And then after that question answer, I saw the devotee was so expert in answering question. And then he said, then after that there were kirtans, dancing kirtan. It was such a wonderful experience, such a joyful experience for me. And then he said, there was 13 item feast prasadam. He said, it was so delicious. I had never had such a wonderful experience. I said, this Hare Krishna is so great. They are so intelligent, wonderful people. And going out of the temple, he saw they were giving some incense and also they were thanking. And in last corner there was one donation box and there was a little boy there saying, thank you uncle, you know, for coming. And there was written donation. So he said, this Hare Krishna is so intelligent. They are giving such a nice experience, and in the end they have put donation box with this little boy. Seeing this smiling, beautiful little boy, who would not like to contribute something? So immediately he put it pockets, hand, he had some notes, then he took coin, he put donation and went. So he started liking, so every week, every month he started coming, and he was very appreciative. One day, after such a wonderful experience, Sunday feast, again he came, same little boy was there, saying, thank you uncle. Then he put his hand in pocket and he saw there were notes, but he made notes aside and then he took a coin he was about to put. And this little boy said, my dear uncle, Krishna doesn't see what you give. Krishna says what you hold back, you know. He said, this little boy is so intelligent, you know. Immediately he put all the coins, all the notes, everything in the note, and then he said, same day I went to the temple leader. I said, I want to just not hold back anything. I just want to surrender. And he said, I joined, you know, by inspiration of that little one. So Krishna looks definitely what we give and he is very grateful. But Krishna also looks at what we hold back. Because that whatever we are holding back is cause of our suffering. Whatever we hold causes of, if we can give that to Krishna, we can see, we can be most happy. Krishna doesn't need anything. So Krishna arranges so many situations in our life so that we can give up holding to this and we can hold to the lotus feet of Krishna. And we can hold to the lotus feet of devotees. We can hold to holy names. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare. So Krishna exactly arranges whatever we need. He arranges exactly the situations. He arranges people, association, exactly what we exactly need. And we see there is a nice prayer that, you know, one devotee says, I asked for wisdom, but God gave me problems. I asked for courage, but God gave me dangers. I asked for love, God gave me troubled people. I asked for favors, God gave me opportunities. I received nothing I wanted. I received everything I needed. My prayers are answered. So, we may pray for something, we may receive something. So we may not get what we want, but actually we'll get exactly what we need. And that is actually kindness and great compassion and mercy of Krishna. So therefore he says, Bhakti Dharma says, sixth point, he says that we should be always accountable to Krishna. We should always know Krishna is watching us within and without. Like nowadays we see many places there is written CCTV camera, beware. As long as people say, oh, CCTV camera, they immediately are conscious. I should be, you know, careful. But actually Krishna is there in heart, always watching. Maybe in CCTV camera sometimes recording we can deal also, you know. We can deal with something and, but the recording of Lord, no one can delete. And he's always watching, so we have to be very careful. We should act in a way it is conducive for our Krishna consciousness, and also it's pleasing to Krishna. We should always understand that actually Krishna is the proprietor and we are just the caretakers. Everything belongs to Krishna, and we should deal with everything, everyone, in such a way that, you know, Krishna is pleased. So we are not, and we should know we are accountable, we are answerable for every part, word and action of ours. Seventh point, he says that we should see every interaction either as gift of Lord or call for, as gift of love or call for love. In our life, so much mercy, so much fortune we get, and we are happy about that. And we should understand, oh, this is Krishna's mercy. This is Krishna's love. Sometimes devotees are very affectionate, they help us a lot. We can say, oh, this is Krishna's love and affection on us. And sometimes we see people are not happy with us. They chastise, they sometimes yell, they may talk with us in such a way, angry way, act in an inappropriate way. So he says that we should see that as actually call for love. Oh, maybe they are not receiving enough love from us. Therefore they are angry, they are upset. But that is also our opportunity to again, instead of becoming envious of them, instead of hating them, instead of just getting rid of them, we should reflect how I can better communicate with them, how I can better serve them. And because those who care for us, those who love us, actually they complain and they shout, they yell. If there's no relation, they won't do that things. If somebody is shouting, yelling, that means, you know, there are some relation there. And it's opportunity for us to, you know, extend, respond to them and see how we can serve them, help them. And eighth thing, he says that we should try to act as instrument of Krishna's love. Actually, we should withdraw from material life. We should absorb ourselves in Krishna consciousness, experience Krishna's love, and then share that with others. More we try to engage our mind and sense gratification, more we will suffer. So when we withdraw, we avoid ourselves from suffering. And when we absorb in Krishna consciousness, serving Krishna, hearing about Krishna, it can nourish us. And we can be happy, we can experience the joy of Krishna, and then we can distribute it to others. And more we give to others, more we receive it. And finally, he says that we should always remember about smar nitya anityatam. One should always remember death. Because if you remember death, we can be focused on our spiritual life. We can prioritize our spiritual life and we won't get distracted. We'll be knowing what is important and what is not so important in life. So this world which we live in is actually mercy of Krishna, and he exactly designed us to help us advance in Krishna consciousness, progress in Krishna consciousness. And if with that attitude, that understanding, we mold our life, then it's very nice. But if we try to enjoy in this world, we should know this world is not designed to facilitate our sense gratification. If we try to do sense gratification, then dukkhalem ashashvatam. And if our goal is Krishna consciousness, then and we act accordingly, then it's very blissful. Vishvam purnam sukhayate, as Prabhupada says, this world is so wonderful. Vishvam purnam sukhayate is very blissful. So this practice of Krishna consciousness is a blissful process. Keval anandakanda, if we align ourselves and sincerely practice, okay? So thank you very much. So in today's verse, Lord is telling about this verse is telling about Lord's compassion and how this world is designed in such a way that conditioned soul can go back to God, and that's Lord's mercy. So thank you much. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. We have a few minutes in case anybody has one question we can take, and those want to leave, they can leave. Okay, Hare Krishna. Mic is there?
In this purport, Prabhupada talks about the atheistic class of men, their mentality, how they think everything comes from chance, how demoniac they are. And sometimes I meet devotees that are very much absorbed in the activities of the demons, you know, that they talk about how they're going to destroy the planet, how they talk about how the demons are conspiring, you know, how they want to eliminate the population, and how they have wars, and they have how they control the banks and the oil, and you know, how they the way they do things, and sometimes it becomes like it's hard to memorize slokas. Some of these Prabhupada's books, we have our head filled with so many things about from the news, you know, or the things from the internet, you know, about people who talk about how the world, how bad the world is. So I was wondering if how necessary it is to really know about so many things outside of Srimad Bhagavatam and Prabhupada's books, that are they a distraction, or is it helpful for us to know, you know, how the families of the demons work and what they're doing and what the news is and what the you know, how many abortions there are, how many cows are being killed, there's so many things, you know, that we can get absorbed in besides the shastras and the scriptures and chanting the holy names. So is everything included just by hearing and chanting about Krishna, or do we need to know like everything else that's going on in the world?
So if I understand your question correctly, that you are saying that how important it is to know about outside world, outside just studying Bhagavatam and living in association devotees. Does it help or it doesn't help? Am I correct? So I don't know about you, but most of us have experience of material life before coming to Krishna consciousness, and our experience was not wonderful. To try to enjoy in this world, this is a miserable place, and it was only coming in touch with devotees and Prabhupada books and association that we know things clearly, and we're able to practice even material life happily by aligning with proper principles. So this is the first thing, that we have come to Krishna consciousness because we have realized that material life, there's no happiness, but by serving Krishna we can be happy. And now one need to be fixed up in this understanding. So we need proper association. These proper principles, people live by these proper principles. So trying to avoid sense repetition and engage in Krishna's service. So wherever the association is there, that is very favorable. And then when we are properly situated under instruction, we may preach out to outsiders also. And when we have to preach, then we may have to deal with them. We need to understand them and accordingly give them Krishna consciousness. Because unless we understand them and present Krishna accordingly, they may not relate to us. We need to relate to them at their level, in their terms, initially to get connection. So maybe we may need to know about outside thing little bit, so that we can connect to outside people, so that we can inspire them to take to Krishna consciousness. But our faith and shelter should be in Krishna consciousness, knowing well that this is a wonderful life, real life. But unfortunately, out of ignorance, people are thinking that there is some, you know, happiness outside of Krishna consciousness. So nowadays we see little tiny demons having very attractive programs of enjoyment. But we see Bhagavatam, very big demons. Like Hiranyakashipu, he had such a big plan for enjoyment and practically was successful in that. We see Ravana, very big plan for enjoyment, and he was practically successful in accomplishing, which we cannot imagine also accomplishing that now. So we see those people who accomplish, they couldn't be happy, they were dissatisfied. So what is hope for these demons? So we see biggest demons, they were miserable, how these demons can be happy? But Kali Yuga, Mahaprabhu is very merciful. This biggest demon, Hiranyakashipu, they came as Jagamadai. Even they became happy by taking to Krishna consciousness. So one should have faith. Even big demon, small demon, everybody has hope in Mahaprabhu's mercy. If you can give them little bit of, you know, Krishna consciousness, little prasad, little association, little things, they have fortune, they have future. But one should not get too much into it and get distracted from our shelter and our this thing. In heart of heart we should know, this is the way to be happy. So as much as we need for preaching purpose or, you know, for our maintenance, we may deal with material nature, do the needful. We can't be just zero interaction, but our heart should be sheltered at lotus feet of Krishna, because that is where bliss is, that is where joy is, that is where real life is. Other life is illusory. Maya is very expert in giving. Though people are suffering, they think they are enjoying. That is Maya. In darkness, it may appear very attractive. But when sun rises, we understand, oh, it's not very attractive. There are better things in life. I don't know whether I answered your question. But no. Okay, thank you very much. Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Nitai Gopremanande. Genuine senior devotees are there, maybe you can discuss with them.